Africa is big. Really, really big. So big, in fact, it's bigger and mightier than China, India, Europe, and the USA combined. If you look at any ordinary Mercator projection map of the world, you probably think that places like Canada and the USA are massive. Massive they are, but those powerful Western nations are a lot smaller than you think. So small, in fact, that literally most of the world can fit inside the African continent. Africa, the second largest continent after Asia, covering about 1/5 of the total land surface of Earth. The continent is bounded on the west by the Atlantic Ocean, on the north by the Mediterranean Sea, on the east by the Red Sea and the Indian Ocean, and on the south by the mingling waters of the Atlantic and Indian Oceans. Our world map is widely misleading. It's all down to the cartographer Gerardus Mercator, better known as Mercator, and his 16th century map projection, a common template for world maps today, which distort the size of countries. Though a convenient way to chart the world, Mercator's map distorts proportion, making some land masses larger than they are in reality. The 1569 Mercator projection was made for navigating the seas, drawing the meridians and parallels as straight lines that cross at right angles, which helped sailors to navigate some of their first treacherous voyages around the world. Mercator initially made globes, later transferring his map from a three-dimensional curved surface to a flat sheet of paper was problematic. Taking the equator at the logical map center consequently left big and confusing gaps near the poles. While a revolutionary tool for captains and explorers, the projection distorts the relative size of the continents to the advantage of the West. On the Mercator map, Africa sitting on the equator, reasonably undistorted, is left looking much smaller than it really is. But Canada, Russia, the United States, and Europe are greatly enlarged. Look at the usual flat map of the world, and it appears that Greenland is nearly as big as Africa. But it's not even close. It is no bigger than the Democratic Republic of Congo. Africa is 14 times larger. Flat maps significantly distort the sizes of countries and continents, the result of converting a spherical surface to a handy rectangle. The area of land masses becomes increasingly exaggerated towards the pole. As a result, we tend to underestimate the size of countries close to the equator and substantially overestimate the size of countries closer to the poles. On our actual planet, Africa is bigger than China, India, and the contiguous US, and most of Europe combined. It also turns out that Saudi Arabia has more area than France, Spain, Germany, Poland, and Italy together. But thanks to one man by name Kai Kraus, a German software and computer graphics guru who caused a stay with a map entitled The True Size of Africa, which shows the outlines of other countries crammed into the outlines of the African continent. He stated on his website, "Africa is so mind-numbingly immense that it exceeds the common assumptions by just about anyone I ever met. It contains the entirety of the USA, all of China, India, as well as Japan, and pretty much all of Europe as well, all combined. And the idea was to roughly put all of them as a puzzle pieces, somehow fitting inside the outline shape of Africa, which is of course just a symbolic image. It may as well have been just blobs to tell the story, but it actually worked pretty well with the real pieces. at least enough to get the idea across in a visual and visceral way. The continent is more than 30 million square kilometers. But this graphic illustrates that the size is not shown accurately on the standard Mercator map, where countries in the center appear smaller than they are. The graphic also demonstrates how easily the whole of Europe could fit into Africa, as well as some of the biggest nations in the world individually. Crater Kaikraus overlaid Portugal, Belgium, the Netherlands, Switzerland, the UK, Japan, China, India, Eastern Europe, Italy, Germany, France, Spain, and the US on the continent. So why was Africa much smaller on the map, you may ask? Well, you can blame the European imperialism for that one. Ancient and modern conquerors chose to make the African continent much smaller, so to exert their power and authority. Luckily for Africa, they were finally exposed by Kaikraus. The term power of representation and representation of power sums up quite well how maps and the rise of the Western nation state system, and with that empire and colonialism, are linked. Sadly, there is no such thing as a perfect map, because the Earth is a sphere, more of a potato shape. It is impossible to map it on a flat surface without errors in proportion. But the Mercator still dominates, and the digital revolution has further strengthened its position. Today, the Mercator projection is used as a template at Google Maps, OpenStreetMap, and Bing. From guiding 16th century explorers on the high seas to helping people find Pokemon on their smartphones, Mercator's work continues to influence how people see the world centuries after his death. Well, Africa is a continent, not a country. But I think you'll be impressed at how much larger it is than you probably thought. Realizing the true size of Africa also helps us appreciate how daunting it may be to solve Africa's poverty and food challenges. And that brings us to the end of this video. Hope that was quite informative. If you haven't subscribed yet, you may consider subscribing to the channel to help push for more videos. Catch you next week with a new one. Peace. I'm out.